Hey guys, welcome back to the channel, and today I'm here for CD Collection Part 6, N through P. So, I don't really have that many for these letters, so it should be not too long of a video. Like Part 5 was really, really long. So with that being said though, let's gonna get started with CD Collection Part 6, N through P. So first for my N's, it's going to be Natasha Bedingfield. This is the only album of hers that I have on CD. I've been wanting to get her debut album Unwritten on CD, but haven't gotten around to it yet, but I will eventually. But for now, I have her album Pocket Full of Sunshine. This is the American version because the original version was called NB without some songs that are on this version of the album. And I actually prefer this version of the album, to be honest. But yeah, you got songs like Pocket Full of Sunshine, Happy, Love Like This from Sean Kingston, Soulmate, Angel, Who Knows, Pirate Bones, Not Giving Up, and some others. So yeah, Natasha Bedingfield and her album, Pocket Full of Sunshine. Definitely a really great album here. And I think Natasha is a very good singer. Okay, next for N's is Nelly Furtado, Loose. This is also the only album I have from Nelly Furtado. This is my favorite Nelly Furtado album. Lots of great stuff. Definitely one of my favorite albums of 2006. So you got songs like Man Eater, Promiscuous featuring Timbaland, Say It Right, Do It, In God's Hands, Wait For You, All Good Things Come To An End, and some others. So Nelly Furtado and her 2006 album, Loose, definitely a childhood album for me. Lots of good memories for me back in my childhood days. So Nelly Furtado and her album, Loose, definitely a great album. Okay, next for the N's is going to be a band that I'll go ahead and show here in a minute after I get to the last album stack. And this is a band who many people love to hate on, but I don't give a damn about that because I like this band. And people might judge me for it, but I can give less of a damn. And the band is Nickelback. This is their album Silver Side Up, my favorite Nickelback album. So yeah, you got songs like Never Again, How You Remind Me, Too Bad, the re-recorded version of Just Four, Hollywood, Money Bolt, Good Times Gone, and a couple others or so. So Nickelback's album, Silver Side Up, definitely a really good album here, and one of their best, and it's my favorite from Nickelback. Great album. Okay, next for Nickelback is The Long Road. So The Long Road by Nickelback. I actually have two versions of this album. I have this, which is the standard edition, and then I have the special edition, which has some extra songs, but however, for the special edition, I don't have it in the packaging, so I'll only show the version that I do have on CD within the case and stuff, and that is just a standard edition of The Long Road. So with The Long Road, you got songs like Flat on the Floor, of course the big song Someday, great song. I know it's an overrated song and overplayed, but still definitely a good song though. Believe It or Not, Feeling Way Too Damn Good, Because of You, Should Have Listened, Figured You Out, See You at the Show, and some other really good stuff. So yeah, Nickelback, The Long Road, definitely a really great album. One of their best, once again. I just like a lot of their 2000s material, for sure. Okay, next for Nickelback is their album All the Right Reasons. So yeah, but this album, it's definitely their most hated album of all of their albums, and I just don't understand why. Yes, it doesn't have that hard rock feel like the first two albums that I showed in the collection. It leans more towards like pop rock, but I still think it's a very good album and does not deserve any of the hate that it gets. Because to me, it's a good album. Got songs like Fight for All the Wrong Reasons, Photograph, Animals, Saving Me, Far Away, the tribute song to Dimebag Darrell, rest in peace Dimebag Darrell. The song is called Side of a Bullet, which I which is a tribute song to Dimebag Darrell, who was killed back in December of 2004. So I'm glad that Nickelback made a tribute to him, because Dimebag is my favorite metal guitarist of all time, so it's definitely a great tribute to him. If Everyone Cared is a really good song, and then the song Rockstar. So yeah, Nickelback, All the Right Reasons, definitely a good album. It'd be my top three for Nickelback. Okay, another Nickelback album. This is their album Dark Horse. This album made me a big fan of Nickelback back in 2008. And I still love this album to this very day. I find it to be quite underrated within their discography. So yeah, you got songs like Something in Your Mouth, Burn It to the Ground, Gotta Be Somebody, I'd Come for You, Just to Get High, Never Gonna Be Alone, Shaking Hands, SCX, If Today Was Your Last Day, This Afternoon. That's the majority of the album that I just listed. And the only reason I've done that is because it's a really good album. So yeah, Nickelback, Dark Horse, definitely an underrated album. And definitely deserves more recognition because I think it's a good album. Next for Nickelback, Here and Now. Not one of their best, but still a good album though for what it is. You got songs like This Means War, Bottoms Up, When We Stand Together, Gotta Get Me Some, The Ballad Lullaby, which is probably one of my favorite Nickelback songs of all time. It's just a really great song. I love that song. Try Not to Love You is another really good song on the album. Holding On to Heaven, Don't Ever Let It In, and some others. So Nickelback, Here and Now. Like I said, not one of their best, but still a good album though. And last for Nickelback, their latest album, Feed the Machine. Definitely a return to form album. Really great stuff. Got songs like Feed the Machine, Song on Fire, Must Be Nice, After the Rain, For the River, Home, Silent Majority, Every Time We're Together, which is one of my favorites on the album. Some others. So yeah, Nickelback and their album Feed the Machine. It's hard to believe that album is already over 4 years old. I mean, it came out in 2017, but just doesn't feel like it's been that long. Damn, time goes by so fast. I just had to bring that up for this album because time just goes way too fast for music. Okay, now guys, we're on to the O's. Now this next band, I would say that I'm more of a person who just likes a little bit of their material, not everything. And the band is Of Mice and Men. This is going to be the deluxe edition of their album, Restoring Force. This is the deluxe edition. So yeah, kind of hard to read the track listing because it's tilted side. It's like wrote a different way. So, hold on guys. With this one, you got songs like, let's see here. Fuck. Bones Exposed. Would You Still Be There? Make Me Sick. And some others. I'm just not going to read that much from this album because it's hard to read. So yeah, Of Mice and Men, Restoring Force, Full Circle, Deluxe Edition. Still a pretty good album. And last for Of Mice and Men is their latest album, Earth and Sky. This was one of my favorite albums of 2019. Definitely a really good album. Comes with a slipcase and some other really cool stuff. So yeah, it's pretty cool packaging for this album. Hold on guys. Looks like that. Pretty cool stuff there. So yeah, Of Mice and Men, Earth and Sky. Man, this shit's hard to put back together. I'll deal with that here in a bit, guys. Sorry about that. I'll fix that here later on, or after the video, because it'd take too much time. And last for the O's, One Republic, Dreaming Out Loud. So yeah, I don't really listen to this album that much, but I think it's okay for what it is. You got songs like Say All I Need, Mercy, Stop and Stare, the original version of Apologize, All Fall Down, Prodigal, All We Are, and some others. So yeah, One Republic, Dreaming Out Loud. Okay, that's it for the O's. Now we got a kind of a huge stack for the... Wait, no, that's not it for the O's. My bad, guys. I wasn't paying attention to the next stack, so apologies here. Alright, Next for the O's, since I have more O's, my bad, it's going to be the band Overkill, definitely thrash metal legends, and this is their album Under the Influence. Got songs like Shred, Hello from the Gutter, Mad Gone World, Drunken Wisdom, Overkill 3, Under the Influence, and Smothers. So yeah, Overkill, Under the Influence. Definitely a good album and one of my favorites from that band. Okay, next is Overkill. This is their album Horoscope. One of my newest arrivals for Overkill. That's what I meant to say. Not bad. Got songs like Coma, Blood Money, Thanks for Nothing, Bare Bones, a title track, Horoscope, New Machine, Frankenstein, Solitude, and some others. So yeah, Overkill on their album Horoscope. Next for Overkill, White Devil Armory. Really good stuff. Got songs like Amorist, Down to the Bone, Pig, Bitter Pill, It's All Yours, and The Name, and some others. So Overkill on their album White Devil Armory. Good album. Not my favorite, but still very good. Next for Overkill, The Grinding Wheel. Definitely an album that is really, really good. I think it's one of the best modern albums. Got songs like Mean Green Killing Machine, Our Finest Hour, Shine On, Long Road, Come Heavy, Red, White and Blue, amongst others. So Overkill and their album The Grinding Wheel. What did I mean by amongst others for that album? I meant to say among other tracks. That's what I was meaning by that, since I felt like listening them all off. So last for Overkill is their latest album. This is the album The Wings of War, another one of my favorite metal albums of 2019. Definitely a really good album. Got songs like Last Man Standing, Believe in the Fight, Head of a Pin, Batshit Crazy, Mother's Prayer, Welcome to the Garden State, Out on the Roadkill, and you even had the bonus track in Ashes. So yeah, Overkill and their album The Wings of War. Like I said, one of my favorite metal albums of 2019. Now, on to the final O's albums, or singer or band. So last for the O's, finally, is going to be Ozzy Osbourne, Diary of a Madman. Really good stuff there. I'm just going to rush through Ozzy here. Bark at the Moon by Ozzy. There's not really much to say because he's a legend in the heavy metal community, of course. Ozzy Osbourne, No More Tears. And then Ozzy, Down to Earth, which is an overhated album, but definitely a good album, though, in my opinion. Does not deserve any hate. Okay, now this next band, mainly a big metal fan back in 2017, I want to say it was. And the band, of course, is Pantera, Cowboys from Hell. Definitely a great album. Pantera, Vulgar Display of Power, which is my favorite Pantera album, many people's favorite. That's how much of a classic and good album it is. Next is Far Beyond Driven by Pantera. This is the 20th anniversary version, so it's got two discs, so it's pretty cool. So yeah, Pantera, Far Beyond Driven. I would agree that it is an overrated album, but it's not bad though. Next for Pantera, The Great Solomon Trendkill, which I think is a really good album. Pretty underrated, if you ask me. Next for Pantera, Reinventing the Steel. And last for Pantera is their compilation, which is called A Decade of Domination. So, yeah, Pantera, definitely a great compilation to have if you like a lot of their most well-known songs. So good stuff there for Pantera. Okay, next for the P's is going to be Parkway Drive. This is their album Atlas. It's the only album I have from these guys on CD, but I've heard a little bit of other stuff. They're definitely a really good metalcore band. On this album, you got songs like Sparks, Dream Run, Wild Eyes, Dark Days, which Dark Days is my favorite song for Parkway Drive in general. I just love how catchy it is. I love it, man. I love the breakdown as well. Just a badass metalcore song. The River was another good song on the album. Swing, Atlas, which is the title track, was really good. So yeah, Parkway Drive, Atlas, good stuff there from them. Okay, let's see here. Okay, just a little bit left for the piece. Now these next four albums are all from the same singer. Definitely a big fan of the singer, and the singer is Pink. This is her album Misunderstood. I don't think it's one of her best albums, but it's still pretty good for what it is. Got songs like Misunderstood, and Let Me Get Me, Just Like a Pill, Get the Party Started, Family Portrait, amongst other songs that are on the album. So yeah, Pink, Misunderstood. Like I said, not one of her best, but still pretty good there for what it is. Because it does have some songs on it that I like. I don't like the whole album, but I like some songs on it. Or a little bit of songs on it, to be more specific. So next for Pink is Try This, another good album from her. Got songs like Trouble, God Is a DJ, Last to Know, Oh My God, Waiting for Love, Save My Life, Walk Away, and some others. So Pink and her album, Try This. Next for Pink, I'm Not Dead. I know this is a censored version, but it is what it is. Still a very good album. Got songs like Stupid Girls, Who Knew, Long Way to Happy, Nobody Knows, Dear Mr. President, the title track, I'm Not Dead, You and Your Hand, One That Got Away, and some others. So yeah, Pink, I'm Not Dead. Definitely another good album from the year 2006. And last for Pink is going to be her album Funhouse. So definitely lots of good songs on this album as well. Got songs like So What, Sober, I Don't Believe You, Please Don't Leave Me, Bad Influence, the title track Funhouse, Glitter in the Air, some others. So yeah, Pink, Funhouse. Okay, and this is the last album for the video and for the N through P's, and it is Puddle of Mud, Come Clean, The Lamb of Theirs that I have on CD. So with this album, you got songs like Control, Drift and Die, Blurry, which Blurry is my all-time favorite Puddle of Mud song. I love that song. Such a good song. She Hates Me. I know that's a hated song, but I still like that one. And Piss It All Away and some other songs. So yeah, Puddle of Mud and their album Come Clean. So yeah, guys, that's going to wrap it up for CD Collection Part 6, N from P. So yeah, guys, let me know what y'all think. And yeah, I'll see y'all next video. Peace.